Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, and welcome back to another vlog right here on my photography-focused YouTube channel. So, if you watched last video, I talked about the weather, which is happens to be identical to tonight, which is beautiful blue skies and not a cloud in the sky. And at the time I said, these are not ideal photography conditions at all because we're approaching sunset and ideally you'd want just the right amount of clouds so that the clouds light up in all the different colors of sunset. You get some orange and maybe even some pink hues, and that makes for a very dramatic, beautiful looking sunset. So I do stand by that statement. But what I've also been thinking about is if you keep waiting for the optimal conditions to come around for you to take photos, they might never come around and you always sat at home and not taking photos, so that's no good either. So I've said, screw it, let's use these less than optimal conditions to head out there anyway, have some fun and take some good photos along the way, hopefully too. So I'm glad you're here to join me, and let's head downtown to Zurich, you know the drill, and then we'll get some good photos hopefully. Let's go. Heimi is the first location I had in mind for today's vlog, and that's Paradeplatz, right here in the heart of the city center in Zurich. And what I just love about this place is it's kind of like a central spot where a lot of trams converge and you can change between lines, so you see a lot of trams coming in and out, and they're kind of very iconic in Zurich. The white and blue trams really makes for an awesome Zurich themed photo every time, just like I used to take photos of red London buses, but in Zurich the buses aren't red, the trams are blue, so that's why I'm here. And it's also got my favorite building in the whole city, and that's the Credit Suisse head office, this one right here. I just think it's incredibly beautiful, an absolutely stunning facade, and yeah, matched by some of the other beautiful buildings around me here. Give a shout out to UBS as well, and some of the older buildings in the old town, which happens just there. So beautiful backdrop, and you can get some amazing foreground off the trams, but let me get out the camera and I'll show you what I had in mind. Here's the situation. I opted for the Sony a7 III, well, that's just my main camera, and then I'm using the Nisi 15mm, which is a wide angle lens, just allows me to capture in as much of the square as possible. And additionally, I also opted for the Nisi Allure Streak 2mm blue filter, which, if you watch my previous vlog, you'll see creates streaks across direct sources of light, in this case headlights. So that was kind of cool in the last vlog, and I wanted to explore that further with you guys. So I thought, let's see if we can catch the headlights of the trams, get that cool effect of the streaks, and then that should make a cool photo with these beautiful buildings in the background. That's the plan anyway. Let's try catch these trams and catch some good photos along the way. Let's go. Only moderately successful. I'm not really happy with those results. The effects of the streaks on the headlamps were very weak, and I don't know if that's because of the wide-angle lens or maybe because the tram headlamps aren't very strong, or it could be a combination of the two. Either way, you win some and you lose some, and by losing you actually learn more than by winning. So I've learned what doesn't work, and with that I can get better results next time. But I do have one more photo location in mind, and yeah, again going out on a limb, trying something new, going for a gamble, but it could be a good photo also. Let me walk to another next location and then we'll talk all about what the next photo I had in mind is. Boom, and just like that we've made it. Here's the next location for the shoot, and I just love this particular bridge I'm standing on right now. Here's the ledge, because you got a beautiful overview of the street going down here, and the sunset would have set back there. The sunset just passed a few minutes ago, so we're reaching that twilight area where there's still a little bit of afterglow in the sun, in the sky I mean, and that's looking lush, creating some beautiful colors back here. But also, with it being twilight, there's no more direct sunlight at all, there's no more shadows, and that makes for some very soft palettes and makes it really easy to get some very soothing, pleasing photos, because you're not dealing with harsh light and shadow and stuff, so really excellent conditions to photograph in. And yeah, the idea is, since we're standing on the bridge here, is to just grab the last bit of glow in the sky, if there is any. And then also, because it's getting evening and the cars have their headlamps on, I'm going to try and get some light trails at the bottom. And for that, the vantage point is just super, because the higher up you are, the easier it is to get beautiful light trails, because they just pass below you. So if you don't have something like this in your city, perhaps try a highway or yeah, just try find a cool spot like this, a little bit of elevation, and you can walk away some amazing light trails. Play around with it and see what you come up with. Setup-wise, I've stuck with the Nisi 50mm wide-angle lens, and now I'm also using some filters, soft graduated filters, just because the sky is a lot brighter up here than the foreground, and just helps me keep the scene a little bit more balanced. And then also I'm using a 6-stop ND filter, which allows shutter speeds of up to 30 seconds at f5.6. Yeah, so 30 seconds, ISO 100, f5.6 is the settings I'm going for, and I'm just shooting lots and lots of photos until I get some light trails I'm really happy with. I reviewed my photos already, they're looking good, scene's looking balanced, just making sure I don't clip the highlights, because the horizon where the sun just set is the brightest part of the photo, of course. And yeah, are you interested in seeing some final results? Let's go check them out. So what did you think of that photo? I'd love to get your feedback in the comments below, because it does help me improve as a photographer as well. And yeah, with that being said, I think that's my final photo for today. I'm going to call a wrap on this video. It's been a fun evening, and I hope you had fun watching me as well. And I hope, more importantly, that I've inspired you to get out there yourself and take some beautiful photos too. Share them with me on Instagram, and I'd love to see what you come up with. But if you want to join me on another adventure just like this, be sure to hit that subscribe button below, and I can't wait to see you in a future video. But with that, it's time to end the vlog. Good night.